Part two. Climbing up the rat pole. Today is the tomorrow I worried about yesterday. She mumbled to herself as she fumbled with the sickening feeling of realizing she drank too much alcohol. And the queasy, hungover morning haze hung before her eyes as she braced for impact with the here and now, while the now and again got naked and sang and danced with the devil by the 60-watt light bulb. But nah, so she ignored that thought. Or rather, she accepted, embraced, and absorbed that thought and let it pass into obscurity, because ignoring the ignorant doesn't make them less ignorant, it just makes them loud, indignant, and ignorant. But the new guy left right away, left to writing and wondering what he meant when he left for the phrase, the man who knows not, and knows he knows not, he is ignorant. Teach him. The man who knows not, and knows not, he knows not, he is a fool. Avoid him. The man who knows not, or who knows, but knows not he knows, he is asleep. Wake him. The man who knows, and knows he knows, he is wise. Follow him. Thus, by real leadership, peel back the layers of superfluous thought and gently settle into the present. Where sober people rarely visit. And the conscious, steady, rhythmic motion of breathing in and breathing out became something in and completely without distinctions between the air flowing in and the blood pumping out of the conscious, steady, rhythmic motion of beating it up and beating it down. The heart, her heart, his heart, their heart, your heart, my heart, our heart. Our heart. Beating and pounding and etching the fact that we live, to learn, to live without the need or want for things that lead to our undoing. She pondered this and resolved to avoid cliches like the plague. And though the past has already passed, tomorrow's only a day away, right? Might as well be free, because it's still too far away to be here and now. Yeah, tomorrow's only a day away. Tomorrow's only a day away. Tomorrow's always one day away. And away and away we go. We hope and we say and we pray to be right. And we left all aside and resolved to say that the grass is always going to be greener on the other side of the fence hence. It's not so bad being who we are. Being where we are, being who we are, being who we are. Are we being who and what we were destined to be? Because when nature calls, she fucking hollers and screams, be born, multiply, die. That's all she says. And the rest, nobody says. The rest is left to us to decide and arrive at our own conclusions. See, we write our own conclusions, and those who say otherwise have taken a sash and covered their minds to keep bits of truth from getting their eyes and reading their complacency. But sometimes no fear means no hope. But the new guy spoke and said, where there's a will, there's a way. Society says, oh, where's my pill for a way out of this reality and into the happy blue tint swirls of Prozac dreams? Viagra wishes, yeah, she wishes. She wishes upon a star and knows full well wishing alone is not going to bring her wishes true. But the moment calls, nevertheless, she takes in awe at the beauty, the precision, the poignant irony of the here and now. She tried to bring the others here, but the stripes of their shirts always got caught in the gray plaid wallpaper, and they would fall into uneasy contention. One day, she thought, one day the bars would bend. One day the toys their friends had caught. One day the toys their friends had bought and pricked. And they would yawn and stretch and be simply awake. Just wait.